Welcome back to another episode of Ark Survival Evolved. My name is Striker, and I have been very, very busy. Yeah, I made a gun. Don't shoot. Don't shoot. Please. Let's see, where is it? Doesn't even have a surrender. Oh, whoops. No. There you go. I guess that's a surrender. Nah. But yeah, I've been building, like, non-stop and taming, like, non-stop. Actually, it's been actually quite a few accidents because I was just running around getting material and then come to find out, boom, there was all kinds of things. And then it's like, oh, what the hell? I got so much meat that it was not so good to eat. So yeah, anyways, I got a surprise for you. Remember the T-Rex that was just down there that, you know, killed my two tames? Well, he came back. He didn't came back up this way, but there was one of those blue drops over there, and so when I went over there, oh my god, he was like right there. He was below me, but apparently he couldn't get to me, so that was good, but I was able to tame him. And so now I got two T-Rexes. Then I went on a mystical journey with him, and boy, he's powerful to take out three Allosauruses. And he was a level 8 or 4? But yeah, I've had him for a while so I can get him increased up, you know? If you know what I'm saying. If you know what I mean. So without further ado, I got a surprise for you. Boom! Look at that! This one right here in the middle is named Lava Rock. Because of his skin, he looks Lava Rock. And you already know about Doom. Because she was the bitch to tame. She is a 98 now. And this one right here is named Snowflake. That was the one T-Rex that got away when I told you I was taming her. Or, yeah, you were her, right? Yep. You are her. When I was taming her, and then I told you about that when I went down because I was dehydrated and I had to get some water and I came back, but I couldn't find her because I was being chased by two sabers. Well, that's her. The same one, because I remember exact location, and she came down a little ways from the mountain, and yeah. This guy is, yeah, you're a guy, right? Yeah, you are. So you're a lucky guy. You got two beautifuls to, you know, do your business. Yeah. Yeah. You like that, don't you? But yeah. Anyways, I finished my garage. It is complete. Yes. And I will show you other things. Also, I got the little garden up and running. Now, I was just screwing around the pipe, so if you see it a little wacky, it's because, I don't know, I'll just, you know, testing out for the first time. Holy crap, these things don't even look like they're really connected. Look at that. They're like a little inch off. So this one looks like it's made out of metal, and this one's made out of metal. This one looks like it's just bronze stone. I don't know, I did it like this because I thought I'd give it twice as more water. I don't know, I was just screwing around with it because it's my first time building my own garden. And I stuck this thing on top. I don't know why, I got this from one of those drops out there. And I didn't know what the hell it was. I know it was like an irrigation water, but I didn't know where it went or how it, I don't know what it was for. When I stuck it on these pipes, it looked like it would snap on. So I was like, okay, so it must be for them. I didn't, because it wouldn't let me snap it onto anything else. So I guess that works. Plenty of water for me. Yeah, probably need to fill my canteen. Okay. I was priority full. And I got the shitting boxes. This one's still damaged, even though I repaired it twice. I don't know why it still says damaged. Dablage. So yeah, it's got the shit in there, so I can fertilize it. And there's whale. You already know about the seeds and stuff. I got so much seeds. But yeah. I'm gonna go on a journey, and I'm gonna take you guys with me. Take you to the mountains of metal. Because I have run out of metal. I only have a bit, but you can only get so much. And I also did some changes on my settings, so, because it got kind of annoying, because, you know, my weight, it used to be 200,100. Well, I changed it back to the normal state, which is, it's now 340.4. Because every time I was over, and even though I could carry things from, like as much as I want, I couldn't ride none of my dinos because their weight level was not that high. So I couldn't ride none of them, so they would just sit here and do nothing. Well, level up, but other than that. But yeah, so yeah, this is the Dino HQ, that's what I call it. Well, this, yeah, I'll show you that in a minute. Also, I got Engineer. Look at that. Yeah. Found her in the same place over and over again until I went up and down the hill that way. And she was still stuck, so I just went ahead and tamed her and named her Engineer. And look at this. This is one of the son of a bitch and sabers that always kept attacking me. But this time I was able to get that T-Rex and her. Yeah, you're her. And I named her, what's your name? Sweetheart? What's your name? Oh wait, it's right there. Shira. Yeah. If you know what that name is, then yeah, you know I like Ice Age. Why not? It works. Still got the two trikes. And got the Velociraptor. Oh, that got a little laggy. But yeah, I couldn't ride her or any of my dinosaurs when my weight was just too big. So since I got maxed out, which is the level 100, there was no sense in me having the weight that big and my experience that big. I still left my experience the same a little bit, because these ones are still leveling up. And when I go to, like, maybe the Scorched Earth or the Center, it's going to have the same settings. So, might as well leave it the same. But the only thing I changed was my weight. Because it's kind of fun to ride these things, you know what I'm saying? Look at this, see? This is kind of fun. Especially when you're out there in the wild. But yeah, I got some meat troughs. Well, food troughs, I should say. One for meat, and you, oh god, it's laggy. Fruit, meat, and probably fruit, yep. And I got these things so I can keep the meat fresh, and the food for backup, I guess. And yeah, you guys all know raw meat. Well, when I was out there just getting some metal over that way, just a little ways where I caught the, tamed the lava rock, I went a little further into the ice dome, the snow biome, whatever. I can't remember how you pronounce that word, biome, dome, or whatever it is. I ran into this son of a bitch. He tried to kill me. I named him Rotten Meat. Look at the level he is compared to her. You are him, right? Yep. And yep. So yeah, I got two lovies right here. Oh, how sweet. And why is there rain coming through here? That's very weird, because rain doesn't even come inside my house. And also, when I tamed him, this one was a bitch to tame. He almost woke up several times. I had to put so much narcotics in him just to keep, keep her tamed. But look at the level she got, 189. Oh my god, she is, and I named her Terminator, because terror birds are actually considered as Terminators. They don't have to be like a machine, no, just to be a Terminator. It's just the way they were during the Ice Age period. They were deadly and mean. If you saw a terror bird in Ice Age, you better pray it doesn't see you, and you better pray that you can run like hell. And hope to God it doesn't. Hope to God you are prepared to face one of these things. I mean, they won't attack you, but if there's like three of them, they're gonna do like what Velociraptors will do. I think that's everybody. Oh, my house. Yeah, that's right. Ah. Yep, there's a gate here as well. And see? Dino HQ. Now, I'll show you the other buildings later on. Right now, I do need to get mail before it gets dark. Should probably do it right now. But I want to be prepared. Also, yeah, I got another bookcase. No, bookshelf for blueprints, because I am getting quite full on that one. But yeah, I gotten a few things here. Got smithy, got this, got fireplace, and a table and a chair, because it's just kind of fun to sit here. I mean, Dover King hasn't logged in a while, so he's off making his world a fun place. So yeah, got two of those. I'm basically getting all myself all kinds of. Oh yeah. I had to build another one of these. I call it the rock. Oh, what the hell? I need to change that. We'll do it later. We'll do it later. I don't know what it says. Well, it says rotten meat, but yeah. Anyways, it has rotten meat and narco berries. Because you have to have rotten meat and narco berries, and you stick them in here to make narcotics. Which is up here. And I have all my cooked meat in this refrigerator. Also. I have, oh god, I even does that. I have this, the fabricator, to build all metal and machine guns, shotguns, and turrets, like minigun turrets. And when you reach a level 100 or 99, you get rewarded with this arc, the artifact of arc. And I had to build that, which it took a lot, but you didn't have to build it in this. No, I just built it in the smithy. And stuck that in there. I didn't know where to put it, so I stuck it on front of my bed because, hell, I didn't know where to put it. And my guns kept my gun cabinet, my ammunition cabinet. I've probably already done this before, but I'm just making sure. And I stuck all my eggs in here. They have been laying eggs, especially the T-Rexes, the two females. They've been dropping like eggs constantly. Every time I pick up one, there'll be another one that would drop on my head. Let's put you away. And armor. Oh yeah, I got a few new armor. Let's see, here's that one. Oh wait. Is this one not the one I'm wearing? So if we put that away. Oh. And put drop you. I got too much meat of this. Ooh. Looks the same, but at least I got something that would probably be a little bit stronger. That thing is still wacky. It's still buggy as hell. It's not supposed to do that. It's supposed to actually make you jump, and I put this ladder all over the place. And it's still. I'm stuck. I can't move. So I have to literally look at the damn ladder just to even get back down. So, I hope Arc can fix that issue because it's just kind of annoying. I can't get on top. How am I supposed to put turrets? I would need a bird for that, but I'm not much of a flyer. I'm more of a ground base. So yeah. Also, I built a wall around my property because it gets kind of tiring when you get attacked by certain things, and especially being robbed. Now, there's these dinos that rob you. They keep taking this gun right here, all the time. Don't know why. You think they would take either my pistol or my shotgun. But they don't, because they're idiots. And. Oh, yeah, I need to get meat. Oh, and my narcotics. Just in case. But yeah, no, wrong place. Now, where's my narcotics? Oh shit, I think I'm right remembering. Yeah, I got quite a bit of stuff. Let's take the maybe 55. Yeah, because all these ones are quite big. Yeah, there's a lot of them. But yeah, anyways, I totally forgot what the hell's talking about. I know I need some meat. Actually, I probably don't need some meat. I can have my T-Rex just kill something and get some meat out of that way. But I do need to take some for the trip so that way they can get hungry. I'll take that much. There we go. Not bad. They don't eat that much anyways. But yeah. Anyways, the dino that stole, let's see, the crossbow and stuff. I forgot what I was talking about. Let's see, who should I take? You or you? Can't you, because I don't have a saddle yet. Oh, why thank you. I definitely need those for my fertilizer. Oh yes. So anyways, I built the fence around because that way I can't get robbed. Plus, now I got a thing to say to you guys. If you want to join my server, please don't rob me. 'Cause two people, I don't know who they were, they joined my server and took a lot of shit. But now think of it. You spawn into my server, you're naked, okay? You don't have very much armor on, you're gonna die no matter what. Plus you can't get away 'cause I am the host, so you can only go so much of meters from my base and me. You won't get far. I had a few people that I don't know who the hell they were. They joined me, went through my shit, even though they weren't supposed to because I had not invited them to my tribe. But somehow they were, and they were trying to run away. But the mistake they did is they ran out this side of the gate. They ran this way. They ran this way and said, "Oh shit!" And then my T-Rex has ended up killing them. Both of them. So, please don't do that. It's not smart. If you're gonna try and steal something from me, you're not gonna get very far. Especially the barrier I put around my area. It goes out far and you're not gonna get out. So, I don't mind if you join, just don't be a dumbass. Like those two people were. Just jump. There we go. Okay, we're off. So right now I am playing on single player so that way nobody can join me. I was planning on hostile so that people can join me because I was waiting for Dovahkiin to join me, but he was having some issues. No. There we go. I wasn't sure if that T-Rex was gonna fit. So yeah. So yeah, if you guys just want to enjoy playing a game by yourself, make sure you click on single player. It brings up the same everything. You don't have to worry about starting all over or anything like that. Just simply, it will just put you back where you left off. So basically, the hostile is just for like multiplayer if people want to join it. Single player is just if you want to enjoy the game yourself. And that's what I intend to do. Also, by putting the barrier up, I don't have to worry about the damn Brontos jumping into my area and they haven't destroyed anything yet, but I don't think they will be able to get in now because. Oh, yeah, I forgot to. Oh my god, are you shitting me? It froze! Well, this was a fun journey. Let's see, try it. No! No! Come on! Fucking lagging piece of shit. This is the one thing I don't like. It freezes a lot, and. But that's okay. It froze again. What a fun journey we're going on to get Meto. Well, I guess I'll see you in another episode of Ark. Drop a like and leave a comment, and I'll see you in another episode. Peace out, everybody. Bye.